friends, welcome back to the tutorial of computer graphics programming in OpenGL. In the previous tutorial series, we were started about the illumination model, that is the lighting effect on the object. We are studying about the local illumination model in this series. Today we are taking the topic about the cone, that is solid cone we are taking, and what will be the effect of the light when we are applying the local illumination model on the cone. The source code is given in the description. You can download the source code from there. Just copy the code and go to the Visual Studio. Today we are taking directly the test project. This is already tested in this one. No need to set the environment variable. If you are starting for the new project, you need to set the environment variable. Because to save the time, I am just started the test, and all the environment variables, if you want to set, you can watch the previous tutorial how to set the environment variable for the Visual Studio for OpenGL. In this one, other codes are same. The basic difference is that here we are also using the idle function, that is we are applying the geometric transformation for the 3D objects also for the cone. We are calling the cone function dot solid cone. This we have already discussed. We are calling rotation function for x, y and z axis, and we are calling the scaling function, and the other thing we are calling the our specular lighting effect. You can call ambient and your diffuse lighting effect, but for the local illumination model, specular is the best thing. You can call the ambient and diffuse also here. Now you can start to execute the project. This is our output for this project, that is the lighting effect of the specular, that is some portion will be more brighter and some portion will be less brighter, and the source of the light is actually at the infinity. So this will be the lighting effect for the local illumination model if you are applying on the cone. You can change the lighting effect based upon this one. This is actually white color. You can change from here the color of the light, and what will be the effect. You can see from here, that is the specular model. We are calling the red color. That is if you in the morning time or evening time, if the color of the reflected ray is red, you can call the red lighting effect. Here the shininess you can change from here, the light position you can change from here, that is this time it is at the infinity, the source of the light is located at infinity, and light is always reflect thrown on the object through the z axis. So if we will change this to 1, that is the source of the light is near to the object, and convert this again to the previous value, see the result. The light is near to the object, so the surface which is near to the light, that is only illuminated, other portion is not illuminated. The another thing we want to call diffuse and ambient reflection. For that purpose, we are having the function in OpenGL ambient, change the value at this place ambient. For ambient, we are using actually ambient model. In the previous section, we know very well that ambient is used especially for the global illumination model. So it has not much effect on the result. We have called the black for color. For the diffuse color, we can call this one the diffuse model. What is diffuse model? Diffusion meaning the surface of the object is actually done. That is no reflection of the light. So what will be the effect? You can see from here for the diffuse model, we are assuming the surface of the object is dull. So the result is in this way. So this is all about the local illumination model for diffuse specular and ambient reflection model, and this is about the solid cone. We can call the wire cone, but for the wire cone there will be not much effect of the light because that is wire shape, and we are calling the rotation function for x, y and z axis, that is geometric transformation we are applying on the solid cone. Other codes are same, you can study from the previous tutorial, other codes are same. If anything is not clear, you can give the comment and I will reply to that comment. Thank you very much for watching the channel. Please subscribe the channel for more videos. This is a OpenGL tutorial series for the computer graphics programming for the beginners.